Chloe Rodriguez is made from the DNA of a former college football player. Not that of her father, who never made a past high school ball, but of a 6'3", 230-pound tight end with blue eyes, blonde hair, and huge calves.
For $169, mom and dad swab the inside of the child's cheek to find out whether or not the child has a specific variation of DNA that would allow him or her to excel in power sports like football.
Youth sports training is a $4.5 billion industry.
The market has exploded as physical education, PE, has disappeared from schools.
Youth sports programs are supposed to teach kids good sportsmanship, which is why a brawl between coaches at a peewee football game in Texas is attracting national attention and outrage.
Parents attacking referees, yelling at young players, even threatening their own children.
I'm gonna get you tonight because you let me down, brother.
No, I'm not.
I don't care if you went and play 100%. I'll get you, buddy. Cry about that.
You can see 11-year-old Nick Nazebeny pinning his opponent, and then suddenly, the other boy's father grabs Nick and throws him off his son.
Rob says he was being paid to play youth football, sometimes in the thousands. The money was a payoff from men who had won bets on his performance.
Well, a 13-year-old from Delaware has already received a verbal agreement on a football scholarship.
There's a new high school football palace being built whose $60 million price tag has some outsiders criticizing.
People are losing their jobs. You're building a $60 million stadium.
A judge sentenced Thomas Junton to 6 to 10 years in state prison for the beating death of Michael Costin at a youth hockey practice.
Two high school football players collapsed while out practicing the heat, and they both later died.
Mark Downs, a T-ball coach outside of Pittsburgh, was arrested for offering an 8-year-old $25 to injure an autistic player before the playoffs. And Downs reportedly didn't want to use the autistic player.
The father who pushed steroids on his own son, and the son who helped send him to jail for it.
I was pushing him for both of us because I liked it and he loved it.
When I was a kid, sports were fun. I always wanted to play in the NFL, but I wasn't big enough. I always wanted to play in the NBA. I definitely wasn't tall enough. I always wanted to be a professional athlete, but I just wasn't good enough. This is my best friend, Leland. He's 6'8". He was the big man on campus. He played basketball at Michigan. He even played pro. He thought it'd be fun to coach and give back to the kids, but no one warned him about their parents.
What's the ultimate goal for your son?
First round draft pick. I shouldn't be telling you this, and I'm actually on probation right now for beating up his last basketball coach.
I've never seen parents so crazy over their kids' ability at such a young age.
He wants me to wake up at...
I want you to wake up at 7 a.m. and do your workout. Working out is as important as your basketball training.
You find yourself living through them, vicariously through them?
Not vicariously, man. Strictly. There's no vicarious about it.
Getting a scholarship, making a team, scoring a lot of points, getting in the newspaper, no matter what, we hang our hats on that. My worth was on the court. Like, I'm always searching for something to take the place of the self-worth that being good at a sport gives you.
After talking to Leland, there wasn't much of a choice. We needed to go on a mission and save the children.
So right now, I'd like you to meet Tiger Woods and his father, Earl Woods.
How old are you, Tiger?
Two.
Well, there you see a youngster, Andre Agassi. Here's a young boy that is 6 years old.
How long have you been playing tennis?
I don't know.
You know, there's millions of people out there that wake up in a life that they didn't choose for themselves.
My will for you, it's a covenant that I'm making with God on your behalf, is that you be number one in the world in tennis, in doubles.
And have you played professionally or in college?
I didn't. To me, it's a learning process because I've never done anything really great.
You guys like getting up at 6 o'clock in the morning to do that?
not too much because I'm tired.
Act like you want to play this game.
I am.
No, you're not.
I am.
And you're not. You're moping around going, how come I'm not getting to play?
I was more aggressive than him because of how I was raised. He was raised by his mom.
I was a mama's boy. I was treated like a little baby.
If you put an S in front of mother, it's smother. So that's what they do. In my day, what we called it was, you're built like Tarzan, you have the heart of Jane. Big, huge dude, but you're just so soft. So it's like,
you're big for nothing.
So that's what I try to get him to train. We get up in the morning, he makes breakfast. We'll watch about an hour of film. He'll take his creatine, take his vitamins, do about an hour of work on the football field. He'll take his creatine again, eat a double lunch, lift weights. Then, of course, he has to eat dinner. And then before he goes to bed at night, I make him take two more calorie drinks, which is another 500 calories, before he goes to bed, which he just got busted yesterday because he didn't do it.
Do you think is that what it takes these days?
For these kids? I believe so.
Do you enjoy doing this? What if he came back tonight after practice and said, I don't want to do it anymore?
I would still make him do it. I would force him to do it. He'll tell you, I cut his friends off in a heartbeat.
How much money altogether did you make in the NFL?
I made a total of, I think, $400.
$400.
Fear does not exist in this dojo, does it?
No, sensei!
Pain does not exist in this dojo, does it?
No, sensei!
Defeat does not exist in this dojo.
I'm going to train your child to physically, emotionally, and psychologically protect themselves for the rest of their life.
We are going patty cake time.
I'm not going to give them a bunch of false sense of security.
You are not at the freaking library. You want me to take you to Joe's karate class? Or you want to be a soul collector?
Soul collector!
Then you better stop training!
They're not going to get a certificate here. They're not going to get a belt here. But I tell you one thing they are going to get here. The reality of being a very confident, powerful individual for the rest of their life.
On your feet! Protect your head when you get up.
Good girl.
On the tire, let's go.
I learned from my mom that you treat your kids like woozy. They're going to end up being woozy.
This is where I calm down my nerves.
It's going to happen. Come on. You want some water? Are you a baby or an adult? You don't need no water right now.
Find me the attitude adjuster so I can slap someone.
You want to go in the ring in front of all those people? Yeah? You wouldn't be scared? No? Why?
Because they're so collective.
And what does that mean?
That means that they never give up.
Have we become like a wimpier society in a way?
Right.
Cut.
I better not even hear you breathe.
The difference in society, Chris, like we were growing up, it's like the pressures on these kids are just so much greater. And the parents try to direct their kids into something when the child necessarily maybe doesn't want to be a part of that.
The first message is just let the kid be a kid. They're seeing and relating to their kid as an athlete who happens to be a kid, rather than as a kid who happens to be an athlete. Most of the athletes, the pros that are out there now, were multi-sport guys. But because of the specialization, now you run into a problem. From ages of 9 to 12, the more they develop what they call the ABCs, agility, balance, coordination of athleticism. The more sports you play, the better athlete you become down the line.
18-1, New York Giants now. World champions, baby.
Did you go through all this stuff?
No. No academies. I mean, no camps. You know where we did all this at? Out in the street.
The biggest difference between the kids these days and my era is they never play pickup ball.
No, these kids mostly, they go through these drills and all that, but they lose a sense of it. I don't know what it is, but
they never get a chance to learn how to play the game from the old guys in the gym.
When these kids in here, they go home after this workout, the kids that's going to make it is going to be the ones working when everybody's gone. When the coach and all them and everybody say, hey, the lights are off, let's go.
Go home.
And you see that one kid over there doing it himself. Now you can have somebody else pushing them, but it's not natural. It's not from the heart. It's not from within.
It's a very thin line between pushing and not pushing enough. I struggle with that myself.
He's not hungry like I was hungry.
You know what? Go look at that. Go look at where all these kids are from in National Football League, in NBA, in Major League. They're not from the suburbs. They're not the kid that grew up in the academy and training every day. They're the kid that had a heart.
And that's the one thing you can't buy.
How much money do you think you've spent?
No idea, man. No idea.
From the time he was a kid.
It was unlimited.
$100,000?
Oh, much, much more than that, man.
Double that?
I'd say 2 Lamborghinis easily, man.
Is Derek a better basketball player than you were?
We've had that bet.
And I had a bad practice or something, and he said he was better than me, and then we bet $1,000 on the game.
You don't get me till I'm in my 40s, man.
Yeah, I beat him 21 to 15.
When you're 10,
I'm 47.
And he was fouling the shit out of me too because he didn't want me to beat him.
You're playing a 47-year-old man.
I'm still a 10-year-old kid, though.
What's the difference, man? What's the difference? You're one of the top five shooters in the country at 10. So you're racking a 47-year-old's ass.
Oh, my God, man. We're talking to you, and you're not watching the game, man.
What you're describing, I did not see.
I know you didn't see it. You were looking the other way.
Okay, that's enough.
Back off. God! Specifically, I have parents that have told me, I'm going to hold my son back for basketball. I said, why are you doing that? And they're like, well,
I want to put some more weight on him. I'm like, well, what do you mean to do? You'll just fail him. I don't know hell.
Is it too early to start drinking?
That's the worst shot I've ever seen.
You gotta be on a swivel, man. You gotta see everything going on, man.
If you wanna win the game, you gotta keep popping.
You're gonna lose, you're gonna fall.
Speed, up and down hills, parachutes.
What's the point of winning? Winning means sacrificing your childhood.
I just see so much more in you, man. That's all. You know, man, I see more.